Hey everyone, I'm Mike Keighley. I'm a 500-hour yoga teacher, a teacher with MaineGeneral and to the Peter Alfond Prevention and Healthy Living Center. I also run an LLC here in Augusta named Archangel Yoga and teach through the Travis Mills Foundation for Recalibrated Warriors. So, if you're joining us, this is our second video of our flow yoga. And so if you remember last time, we did some sun salutations, kind of like a little yoga warm-up, and also like a little bit of integration before we built into our sun salutations. So this evening, what we're going to be doing is building onto that and adding another sequence of standing poses, and then we'll work our way back down onto our mat for Shavasana, for a little bit of rest. So before we get moving, definitely talk to a doctor prior to, you know, if this is your first time doing yoga or if you're unsure if yoga is for you. And where you're at right now in your body. So if you have any concerns over that, any prior injuries or anything like that, definitely recommend talking to a doctor first. Also, if at any point, you know, you become lightheaded, you know, or you experience like really sharp pain, numbness, tingling, you know, that sort of thing, then again, definitely want to consult a doctor and would definitely want to stop doing what we're doing. Let's get into it. So to get started, we're going to start in child's pose. And so if you remember from last time, we're just starting on our knees, bring our knees out about the width of our mat, bring our big toes together in the back, and then we're just bringing our sit bones, our hips, down onto our heels. And so if this is too much on the knees, feel free to find something, you know, maybe a pillow we can put underneath our sit bones, or maybe a block or a book or something like that. And then from there, just going to go ahead nice and slow, and we can extend our arms out and feel free to come up onto our fingertips. If our forehead makes it to the floor, rest our forehead. Or again, if you have a book or a block, feel free to put that underneath your forehead. And then from there, if you want it to be a little bit more restorative, then go ahead and just rest on our forearms, our palms, down onto our mat. So go ahead, just breathing to our belly. Feel free to rest our eyes and maybe noticing the sensation of our breath, our belly, our ribs expanding, and just settling in, just checking in. And so while we settle in, I figured I'd read a little maybe inspiration. And so it's from the book The Daily Stoic by Ryan Holiday. And so it's a collection of quotes and kind of followed by his thoughts on it if you're interested. And so this quote's from Marcus Aurelius. And so it says, "Your principles can't be extinguished unless you snuff out the thoughts that feed them. For it's continually in your power to reignite new ones. It's possible to start living again, see things anew as you once did. This is how to restart life." Interpret that how you need to, but if you're, you know, maybe looking for a little motivation, I know sometimes it can be hard to start something new or to get back into, you know, some of these healthy habits that we had before. And so it's kind of just a good reminder that, you know, you're always able to do that. We're always there. You know, if it's yoga, we can always come back to our mat. If it's running, you know, any other thing that maybe healthy eating, you know, just because we didn't do it yesterday, maybe we fell off the wagon. It's okay. We can come back to it. So go ahead from here, from our child's pose. We're just going to go ahead, press down into our fingers, our hands, come up onto our knees, and we're going to transition to our first downward facing dog. And so we're just going to go ahead, tuck our toes, lift our hips, and bring our body into that inverted V. So we want our hands out a little bit wider than our shoulders, pressing down through our fingers, through each knuckle of our fingers, through that area, that webbing kind of between our palm, between our index finger and our thumb. And feel free here to bend our knees and then maybe rotate our pelvis towards the ceiling a little bit more. And then go ahead, try and straighten the legs, try and get those heels down onto our mat. And also while we're here, just let our head hang, bring our gaze back towards our feet. Continuing to breathe. nice and slow, walk our feet towards our hands, or hands towards our feet, either way. And just come on into a forward fold, a nice ragdoll. And so this isn't like a super active stretch or anything. We really just kind of want to let our arms hang, let our head hang. We can put a generous bend in our knees, rest our belly on our thighs. Just want to hang. Maybe notice our breath in our belly against our thighs. And on our next inhale, just go ahead, come halfway up to our flat back, flat spine. And so just like we're extending through the crown of our head forward, tailbone back. And then as we exhale, go ahead, just fold back over, forward fold. And then inhale, rise all the way up to standing, upward salute. And exhale, hands down to heart center. And we're just gonna take a couple breaths here, kind of closing out as our integration as we move into our warm up. And so we're gonna work through a couple Sun Salutation A's and a couple Sun Salutation B's just to start to get some heat generated. Towards the ceiling with our fingertips, find that upward salute. And exhale, hinge at our hips, forward fold. Inhale, flat back, flat spine, hands on our shins. And exhale, drop our hands down, feet come back. High to low plank, our chaturanga. Lower down onto our bellies. And then inhale, pin our shoulders, our elbows back, cobra as we inhale. And exhale, downward facing dog. Pressing down through our palms, through our fingertips. Feet out maybe a little bit wider than our hips. I like mine out, you know, the width of the mat. Just see how it feels. And then feel free, you know, bend one knee at a time, kind of walk our dogs out. Continuing to breathe. And then go ahead on our next exhale, just walk our feet towards our hands or hands towards our feet. Find that forward fold. Maybe a little bit more active here than our ragdoll, just reaching for our toes. Doesn't need to be, you know, we can still bend our knees. And then next inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, fold, let it go. And inhale, rise to standing, upward salute. And exhale, fold, hinge at our hips. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, high to low plank. Hands come down. Elbows stay in, shoulder blades together as we lower. Inhale, cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. So feel free here, walk your dogs out. You know, sometimes I find it feels good, just kind of wiggle my hips back and forth. Maybe really press down into those palms, press them forward, push our tailbone back and up. Find length. And on the next exhale, go ahead, walk our feet towards our hands. Forward fold. Next inhale, halfway lift, flat back. And exhale, fold. And inhale, rise to standing all the way up. We'll do one more Sun Salutation A. And exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, high to low plank. Elbows in, shoulders in. Inhale, cobra. And exhale, fold. And then inhale, sit our sit bones back, bring our feet in together, big toes in together, sit bones come back, weight on our heels. Extend our fingertips up, just forming like a straight line from our fingertips down towards our tailbone. Chair pose. Just hang out here for another couple breaths. And go ahead, exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, high to low plank, lower down. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Right foot is going to come forward. Warrior one on the right side, so that back left foot. Left toes are angled at a 45 degree angle. Fingertips extend up towards the ceiling. Right knee over right ankle. Want our hips square to the front. Go ahead, exhale, drop both hands down. Right foot comes back as we lower. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Left foot comes forward. Warrior one, left side. Inhale, rise. Reach up through those fingertips. Get nice and low with our hips. And exhale, both hands come down. Left foot comes back to say hello to the right. Exhale, lower. Inhale, cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. Take a few breaths here. And next exhale, go ahead, walk or hop our feet forward towards our hands. Inhale, flat back, flat spine. Exhale, fold. And inhale, chair pose. Bring our big toes in together, sit bones come back. Weight on our heels, we inhale up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, high to low plank. As we lower, elbows in, shoulders in. Inhale, cobra, open our chest. Exhale, downward facing dog, and then transition that right foot forward. Warrior one, right side. Inhale, come on up. And exhale, come on down, both hands down. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Left foot comes forward. Warrior one, left side. Inhale, rise, get those fingertips up. And so when our arms are extended, sometimes there's a tendency our shoulders kind of scrunch up towards our ears. See if we can still sit our shoulders down and back. Extend up through those fingertips, though. Open that chest up. And exhale. Both hands come down. High to low plank. Inhale, cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. Whew. And so if you're breathing heavy, if you're hot, so am I, but completely normal. So just try breathing it out through our nose. If we need to take child's pose, you know, absolutely nothing wrong with taking child's pose. Take a breather. And then go ahead from here in our downward facing.
dancing dog. We're just going to go ahead, bring our left foot into the center line of our body, and then raise our right foot up, so we're in three-legged dog. And then bend our knee about 90 degrees. And then we're just trying to stack our right hip on top of the left. So we're just opening like our right hip to the right side of the room. Trying to open up our front body there, a little bit of our side body. And then we can go ahead and drop that right foot back down. Bring our right foot in center line with our body. Bring that left foot up and back. If you have house plants, kick your house plants. I'm kidding, we don't want to kick plants, they're friendly. Sorry. And then we're gonna bend that left knee. And then just stack that left hip over the top of the right. And then whenever you're ready, go ahead and bring that left foot back down. A couple breaths in our down dog. Probably feeling it in those shoulders. And so from here on an inhale, we're just going to go ahead and bring our right foot up and back, straight leg. And then without swinging forward, we're just going to go ahead slowly, mindfully bring our right foot between our left and right hands. And if we need to drop down onto our knee and, you know, grab a hold of that right foot and bring it forward, do that. We're just setting up for a crescent lunge. And so we want to be up on the ball of our back left foot, that left heel up. Try not to have it too far down. Right toes pointed at 12 o'clock. Try to get our right knee over the right ankle. If we find that we're really far forward of it, then bring that foot forward, the right foot forward. And then from here on an inhale, I'm just going to go ahead, rise up. And so notice here there may be some instability. Good opportunity. Bring our belly button in towards our spine. Engage some of that core. Fingertips come up. Seat our shoulders down and back. And then go ahead from here, just bringing our hands together down to heart center. And then just taking a twist here in our crescent lunge, bringing the outside of our left elbow to the outside of our right knee. And so again, pay attention here. Sometimes we tend to scrunch our shoulders. So really try to elongate through our spine, and that'll also help with your twist. And so you can bring this right shoulder back, really try to open up. And then from here, gently, we're gonna go ahead, we're just gonna rotate open to warrior two. And so we're going to bring our back left foot flat on our mat. Left toes are pointed off the left side of our mat. The right toes still at the 12 o'clock. Keep that bend in the right knee. And then from here, right arm is going to come up in front of us, left arm behind us. You may need to shift your feet. So like your right heel, you want bisecting like the arch of your left foot. Bring our gaze out over that right middle finger. Hips are open to the left side with kind of like a slight forward rotation in them. They're clearly not going to be able to be squared to the front of the room, but just a little bit of a rotation. And then roll our shoulders down and back, open our chest, make room for that breath. And then from here, go ahead and reverse our warrior, bring that left arm down, and then right arm up and back. Maybe see if we can bend that right knee a little bit further into this. And then exhale, go ahead and drop the right forearm on top of the right thigh. Extend the left fingertips up, extended side angle. And then go ahead on an exhale, drop both hands down. Right foot comes back to say hi to the left. Lower. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. And then just doing it on the opposite side. So this time, left foot comes up and back. Hello, Mr. Plant. And then go ahead from here, bringing that left foot forward between our left and right hands. And then back on that right ball of our foot. And then when we're ready, when we got our balance, we got that left knee over the left ankle, we're ready, we're gonna just gonna go ahead, rise on up, get solid, get strong, use our core. Reach with those fingertips, roll those shoulder blades down and back. Open up. Breathe. And then from here, hands down to heart center. Take our
our twist to the opposite side. So right elbow, right chicken wing, just outside of that left knee. Get a little snap, crackle, and pop maybe. Go ahead, just extending through the crown of our head. And then whenever we're ready, rotate on up, warrior two, left side, right arm comes back, left arm is out front, right toes off the right side of the mat, left toes, 12 o'clock, left knee over left ankle, roll those shoulders down and back, open the chest, kind of rotate our hips slightly forward, breathe. And then go ahead, reverse our warrior, drop that right hand down, left arm comes back. And then extended side angle, left forearm on top of left thigh, right arm up and over. Reach, reach, reach. And go ahead, let's get out of there, drop both hands down, left foot comes back. Lower down, high to low plank. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. And then go ahead on our next exhale. We're just going to walk our feet towards our hands. And so we'll find ourselves in a forward fold. And so what we want to do here is use our middle finger and our index finger. And if we're able to, we're just going to go ahead and wrap them around our big toes. And then from here, we can keep our knees bent. So we're gonna keep holding on to our toe, but we're gonna inhale and try to come up to that flat back, flat spine as much as we can. And then go ahead from here while we're in this, see if we can maybe straighten our knees a little bit. And then from here on an exhale, hinging at our hips, folding forward, maybe pulling with our toes a little bit, just getting that nice deep hamstring stretch, trying to bring our forehead to our knees, our belly to our thighs with straight legs. And then go ahead, release our toes, can bend our knees. On an inhale, come on up to our flat back. On an exhale, just fold. And then on our next inhale, we're gonna go ahead, come on back to our chair pose. Sit bones come back down low, weight on our heels. And then from here, bring our hands to heart center. And then go ahead, twist to the right. So left chicken wing, left elbow outside of the right thigh. So just in a chair pose twist. And then go ahead, when you're ready, release. Lower. We're just going to go ahead, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Fold. Inhale, chair. And just twist to the opposite side. So hands come down to heart center. Outside of our right elbow, outside of that left knee. Twist, open to the left. To low plank for the last time tonight, today, whenever you're doing this. Just lower down nice and slow onto our bellies. And inhale, cobra. Shoulders down and back, elbows together. Open that chest, open that heart. Exhale. Go ahead, come on back down.
So from here, we're just going to roll onto our backs. And so on our backs, spring the bottoms of our feet flat on our mat. Knees are bent at about 90 degrees. And then we're just going to take some spinal twists before we settle in for Shavasana. So just give us an opportunity to let our heart start to kind of come back down, cool down. So from here, we're just going to wrap our right leg over top of the left. If you know you have lower back issues, especially in twists, you may want to take like a cushion or a pillow and put that on the left side of your hip or maybe underneath your left thigh or those knees, and that way you don't come over as far. But go ahead, bring our arms out to our sides. If you're like me and you got a wall right here, there's not really enough room, then we can do some goddess or cactus arms, just bend our elbows. And then go ahead, we're just going to lift our hips, scoot them over to the right like 2 inches, and then nice and slow, just let our legs slowly fall over to the left. And we can look out over our right shoulder if we want to go a little deeper. Then go ahead whenever we're ready. Come on back up. Bring that right foot down. Wrap that left leg over top of the right. Scoot our hips to the left. And then just let our legs fall over to that right side, nice and slow. Get as comfortable as you can. You know, if you got a blanket you want to throw over the top, if you're barefoot you want to put socks on, do that. If you got a hoodie you want to put on, kind of pull it up over your face, that's fine. But just laying down, you know, if you feel free to throw something on your knees, take some of that pressure off our lower back. But just get comfortable. And just take this last minute, couple minutes here. Just kind of let everything settle. Let it marinate. Good opportunity to check in with your body and your mind and maybe notice if there's any kind of differences in physically, emotionally, mentally, how you feel. And maybe there isn't, and maybe there is. And either way, totally acceptable. So you guys are welcome to stay in Shavasana if you need a few extra minutes of rest. And if not, it's all good. Feel free to come up. Really appreciate you guys joining. If you have any comments, questions, suggestions for future classes, you can call the Maine General Prevention and Healthy Living team at 207-872-4000.
4102. But yeah, appreciate you guys joining.